Okay, this is my primary ball that I use. It's a basketball. I like it because it's normal. I use it for all my spinning, things like this, right? So, right. So first thing you need to learn is how much air to have in it. This ball is inflated to NFL standards. I get these at Walmart. It's my favorite ball. They're a good rubber. They have a good traction. But what first thing you do is find a height to throw the ball and try hitting it with your head, okay? Control it. So the thing you want to do is be able to really stay underneath the ball and hit it in that square part of your head. Good practice. So I'm bouncing it. Turn. Also helps to get a control over your high bounce, your low bounce. And I suggest before you juggle, you should be able to stall the ball from a bounce. Okay, so as hard as that seems, there are no shortcuts. So one of my practices before I even start in the day is to stop the ball. Okay, so that's something you need to learn with all different sizes of balls. I would use your primary ball first. The one that you're going to perform with. And then I have several other practice balls. When Francis Brunt taught me this, he really encouraged me to try different balls. This one here is very inflated. It's kind of got uneven edges. It's a mini soccer ball, so it doesn't bounce. Spin against, but it's very good. So you have to practice with different kinds of balls. I'll try. There we go. Okay. So it's important to learn to stall the ball. Next one that I learned from Francis was very incredible. The tennis ball was very difficult. That's the fun one about this. I can install that, but we don't have enough time. Video. Another one is my show ball. I love the silicon, so I is to master that. Really have a good bounce. Okay, now to improve your bounce, you can do several things. You can try tricks. One thing I really think you should do is learn to throw the ball to a bounce. Like this. Okay. Make it clean. Don't use your nose. When you throw it up to your forehead, don't let it touch your nose. Okay? That's really going to improve your flat spot when you go to bounce. So, knowing where that is very important. Okay. So, next thing you need to do is practice different kinds of bounces, maybe shoulders. Really help because you're off. Purposely missing off to the side.
something I need to work on.
So you go shoulder to shoulder, head to shoulder, and all that. So that's your first thing, is really mastering bouncing a ball. See how many times you can do it. To do 20 bounces takes a lot of practice. Let's see how many I can do just bouncing the basketball. So as you see, my primary ball, I have very good control.